You are welcome to analyze these concepts with any questions. If you are more light on any subject, or you have doubt, if you are not able to agree anything, you are welcome. We will analyze. Yes.
Could you talk a little bit about the issue of speed? The world, in many contexts, seems to be going faster and faster and faster. And what impact does this have on our consciousness and our ability to drop?
When you're saying the world is going faster and faster and faster, what is the impact of this living on our consciousness?
The more faster, difficult to drop. Because you get more information. And too much of stress, so much of processing is going on, you forget to question the basic things. See, one important thing, when everybody is engaged in so much of work, you forget to question the whole system. You have no time to question the basic system. Because so much of load is there to be finished, to be done, to be accomplished. Where is the time to question the final basic questions? Where is the time to raise the basic doubts? That is why, in India, the first thing they do is, in their education system, to raise the basic doubts. Till the age of 25, nobody can take up any job. They have to raise all the basic doubts and live with it. And question again and again, search. Only when they achieve the balance of discovering the answer into their being, only then they are allowed to enter into the life, whether to marriage or to earning, making money. Till the age of 25, it is called the period of brahmacharya, means studying, living with existence, living with doubts, searching in your self. Of course, the more the speed, less the possibility of dropping. You can drop out, not drop in. Yes. Yes, there are many cases. See, when you drop in, what happens after that is many, totally different. But dropping in is only one thing. Once you drop in, then what happens? When you raise, it raises in thousands of ways. Somebody goes around the world and preaches. Somebody just sings and dances like Meera. Somebody sits under the banyan tree like a Buddha. Somebody just walks naked like a Mahavira. There are so many expressions after dropping in. But the dropping in is common for everybody. After that, when you raise in thousands of ways. See, Ramana Maharshi himself never sat in one 10x10 room. He went round in the whole city. That at least in that city, he never went out of that city. Inside the city, he was walking and living around. But his disciple was sitting inside one room. So each one has got their own method of express. Buddha was quiet and silent, peaceful. Krishna was singing and dancing. So, it's totally based on individual's experience. Yes.
It sounds like this is by design. Things are speeding up so much until we cannot drop.
I think you must take little time to doubt the basic conclusions. The other day I read a beautiful book, The Final Theory. The book, Final Theory, if you have read that book, you will. The basic ideas about the gravity, Newton's law, Einstein's theory, everything is questioned. Everything is questioned. And actually when I read the book, really I was shocked. how did we miss such basic things? When we accepted Newton's theory or Einstein's theory of relativity, we felt almost everything, at least I felt when I read all those things, I felt everything is answered. Everything is in place. But when I read this one book, Final Theory, the whole thing is shaken now. There are so many basic questions we have not raised at all. So before going further, we must raise some basic questions. We must have time to doubt the basic things, and we can't put the responsibility on the society. It is speeding up, it is this, it is that, I can't. Of course, when you say you can't, you will go with it, no problem. But if at all you want the truth, the ultimate experience, or if at all you are really in such a bliss, see, there are two things. We are searching, see, some people are searching the status, some state. If you want the state of mind, blissful state of mind, okay. Or if you are searching for a status, you can run with the speed. Status is different, state is different. If the state comes, status will follow. If the status comes, you can't be sure that state will follow. State will follow. So, if you really want to achieve the state of bliss, you have to question the basic assumptions which you made. Yes. The first step is to drop this idea. Mind will empower you. Mind is too difficult. I did so many times, mind never accepts. These are the ideas which you have given so much of strength to these ideas. Just try to relax from these ideas. Decide for the next 10 days, I will not repeat these ideas into my mind. I will not allow these words to come in my mind. Just for 10 days. Just for 10 days, don't give power or strength to these words. It is very difficult to drop, Swamiji. You don't know. Saying is very easy, but doing is very difficult. I have tried many times. It is very solid. Mind is very complicated. Just don't give power for these words for 10 days. 10 days repeat. No, mind can be dropped. After all, I am thinking. Nobody else is sitting in you and thinking. I mean, are you sure that nobody else is sitting inside you and thinking? You are only sitting and thinking. When you are sitting and thinking, why can't you change? It's after all you, before it is you who create the word, word by word, and create a sentence. Moment the first word comes, catch it. Why do you allow the whole sentence to come out? Then you go around, oh, this is difficult, this is difficult, this is difficult. The moment the buzzword comes, catch. Say stop. 10 days I am going to give you leave, holiday. So just from today, 10 days decide. For next 10 days, I will not give power to these words. And after 10th day, it will never come back, I tell you. I tell you, because I am working with thousands of people. I am working with not only thousands, I can say lakhs. In the last 2 years, I have met 250,000 means 2.5 lakh, how do you say?
Quarter million.
Quarter million. 250,000 people I have met individually. And I have 2,000 healers doing healing service in 400 centers in 20 countries. With all my experience, I tell you, I have seen at least 10,000 people like you who ask this question. Same question. All the 10,000 can drop. And there are many thousands who are successful. Just for 10 days, not more than that. I am not asking you more than that. Just for next 10 days, decide. I will not repeat these words and give power to these words. Just these are words, pure words. And it is you who create words, self-contradicting words, and get into the trouble. And it is purely words. You go and stand in a corner of a room and you say, oh, I am in a prison, I am in a prison, I am in a prison. You never turn and see the third side. You never see, turn and see that you actually the room is open. You, that's two walls. You go and stand in the corner of the two walls. Oh, I am in a prison, I am caught. But you never take time to turn this side and see. You are free. You are liberated. You are always hitting yourself with the second person and third person. Means that outer world, you never look into the first person to see you are liberated. First of all, there is no first person. You always hit your face in the second person and the third person in that wall, and you think you are bound. Just turn, there is no first person. Neither you are bound nor you need liberation. Because there is no first person. All your fears, your worries, your feeling of separateness is built on the idea of your being first person. Your idea of the I, first person. The first person itself doesn't exist. He is not there as you think. As you think, he is not there. Just turn in and see, he is not there. Then why do you need to liberate yourself from the second person and the third person? There is no need. But as long as you are hitting your head against the second person and the third person, you will never be liberated. It's like you are hitting your head on the wall. You can never be liberated. The moment you turn in and see, the moment you fall in, you will see that there is no first person. You are just fighting with your concepts. You are just fighting with your assumed fears, assumed boundaries, assumed anxieties, the fear of separateness is nothing but the concept. It is just based on, built on the concept that you are somebody. When you look, you will understand you are not as you think. Please, can you be a little loud? Same way, look at the thing in a very curious way. That's the first step. The next, I'll try to help you by hearing after the class. Both, I think, hope it will help you. Of course, you will do the same thing every day, but in a different way, much better way, that's all. Because you will not, your energy will not be sucked as it is sucked now by your psychological worry. As on now, 80% of your inner chattering is taken away by unnecessary worrying. If you just do this simple experiment. Speak whatever comes to your mind for 10 minutes and record it. Whatever comes, don't edit. Just speak out and record it. Then transcribe the tape. Transcribe it. Write it down. Read that page. Not even 10% will be directly related to your life or going to help you. Not even 10% of the thoughts will be directly related to your life. simply something will be going on in your mind, and it's almost like running an asylum, lunatic asylum inside. Each sense is pulling itself. So many different kinds of thoughts, you don't even know. But once you drop the past, once you start living in the present, once you start experiencing the consciousness, the wasting energy will not be there. You will not be drained so easily. We are drained so easily because even to take a single decision, you have to move your file through 10,000 tables, 10,000 of your energy clots has to say yes, only then you will be able to take one decision. If that energy clots are removed, you will be able to take that same decision in a single second. The other day, the doctor, Collins, that's his name, Collins was doing a research on my neurological system just 3 days ago in St. Louis. He was associated with some universities, he was working, and he was doing a research on my brain, what happens at the time of meditation. And he says his right brain is so active, many times more than a left brain. And it says, Swamiji, the information in your brain will be processed so easily and so quickly. If the left brain takes minutes to process some information, right brain takes only a fraction of a second to process that same information, and simply will be giving decisions without any worry. And he says one more thing, the right brain is more related to the global thinking and timeless zone. You will be continuously experiencing the timeless awareness, which is the greatest freedom. Time bound awareness or space bound awareness is what we call bondage. Bandha, we call it in Sanskrit, bandha, bondage. The timeless awareness and spaceless awareness is what I call mukti, the enlightenment, liberation. So all you need to do is drop the past, you will be able to do your job much better way, much more creative way, much more beautiful way, much more spontaneous way, much more responsible way. According to me, the ability to take spontaneous decision is what I call responsibility. If you are able to take spontaneous decisions, if you have the ability to take the spontaneous decision, you are responsible. You have responsibility.